So the reaction of calcium with water is Ca plus twice H2O giving Ca over Y2 plus H2 hydrogen. Twice K plus twice H2O giving twice K over H plus H2 gas. Plus H2 gas. So calcium and potassium, they react with water and liberate hydrogen gas, forming their corresponding hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Then question number 3. So students, open your book and see the page number 46. There is some long question, and such long question you should understand it. So see the question number 3. I have got the book, I have opened. Okay. See, let us understand first. Samples of 4 metals A, B, C, D. Samples of 4 metals A, B, C, and D. So these are the metals. And see, where taken and added to the following solution. Added to the following solution. Iron sulfate. Then here copper 2 sulfate. Then third bar zinc sulfate. And fourth is the silver nitrate. Now let us understand about this. So iron sulfate, iron 2 sulfate, A. Here, they have here no reaction. Now this A, when added into the iron sulfate, there is no reaction. That means metal A is less reactive than iron. Remember, here regarding the copper sulfate, there is a displacement. So that means metal A is more reactive than copper, but less reactive than iron. Here there is no reaction. Here there is a displacement, and therefore there is a chemical reaction. And what will here zinc sulfate? Regarding the zinc sulfate, we will say that no reaction. Why we say no reaction? Because this A metal does not react with the iron sulfate, and as the zinc is more reactive than iron, therefore this metal A will not displace the zinc and will not displace the silver from silver nitrate, and therefore here also no reaction. Here also no reaction. Remember, have you got the idea? Metal A cannot displace the iron from iron sulfate. That means metal A is less reactive than iron. In the EMF series or in the activity reactivity series. In the reactivity series, we have seen the reactivity. See here, I again write the reactivity. K, calcium, sodium, potassium, sodium, calcium, then magnesium, then aluminium, then zinc, then Ab, then Pb, then H, then H, then copper, Ag, Au, Ag, Ag, and Au. So this is the activity. So let us see, the metal A can displace the copper from copper sulfate solution. That means this is more reactive than copper, therefore metal may be because activity series elements are arranged with the decreasing order of their activity, and therefore metal may be PB. Just we will think that metal may be just right here PB. Just we are guessing. Then metal B here displacement. Metal B displacement. Now displacement means this metal is more reactive than iron and therefore can displace. Metal which is more reactive than iron is the zinc, and therefore zinc can displace iron from iron sulfate, or aluminium also, Mg also, calcium also, so zinc. But here, now regarding the copper sulfate, what will happen? Regarding the copper sulfate, there will be displacement. Then here for zinc, they have written no reaction. So no reaction means it is a zinc. As there is no reaction means the B metal is the zinc. And see here I write zinc. And regarding the silver nitrate, what they have written? They have written nothing. And here there will be displacement. There will be displacement. So in this question, this part is empty in the book. And here I am telling you that the metal B is more reactive than iron, therefore can displace the iron from iron sulfate, copper from copper sulfate. And here also the space is blank, and therefore we have written here displacement will take place. Zinc sulfate, zinc cannot displace zinc, therefore no reaction, but here there is a displacement. Then C, here no reaction. Here there is a no reaction. Here they have given no reaction. Now see, with iron sulfate C do not react. If there is no displacement. Here also there is no displacement. Here also there is no reaction. Means no displacement. And here is a displacement. In the book there is a, and therefore which will be that metal? The metal will be copper. So see, metal will be copper. And regarding the D, there is no reaction. Then no reaction here, no reaction, and here no reaction. So there is such matter that it does not react with iron sulfate, copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, silver nitrate also. That means this metal B having less reactivity than silver nitrate, and metal having less reactivity than silver nitrate is Au. And therefore how we arrange this? For example, B is more reactive than A, A is more reactive than C and C is more reactive than A. So this is the order of reactivity of the metals A, B, C, D. Remember, note down this question, you will understand. And again, then there will be a regular classes in our school. Again, if you find difficulty in understanding this question, I will explain it. Then, which gas is produced? Which gas is produced when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to the a reactive matter? Hydrogen gas is liberated. For example, reactive metal when added into the dilute hydrochloric acid, hydrogen gas is liberated. For example, Zn plus H2SO4 gives ZnSO4 plus H2, or Zn plus twice HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. Then write chemical reaction when iron reacts with dilute H2SO4. Now iron reacts with dilute H2SO4, Fe plus H2SO4 gives FeSO4 plus H2. FeSO4 plus H2. Fe plus H2SO4 gives FeSO4 plus H2 gas. Ferrous sulfate will be formed. Next question, number 5. What would you observe when zinc is added to the solution of iron sulfate? Write the chemical equation next. Now zinc is added into the iron sulfate solution. Iron sulfate aqueous giving ZnSO4. So in this case, zinc is more reactive than iron. Therefore, zinc displaces the iron from its salt solution, and we get the zinc sulfate. And Fe gets displaced. So this is the chemical equation, and we have seen that zinc is more reactive than iron, and therefore displaces the iron from its salt solution, that is FeSO4 solution. And here we will stop. Again, we will continue tomorrow.